guys, this is Mark. In this video, I'd like to introduce a new feature that we just made available in Backendless Database called Generated Columns. I believe it is one of the most exciting features that we've done in quite some time. There were a lot of releases, a lot of new features, but that one is really at the top of my personal list of how cool and exciting it is. So let's talk about generated columns and what they are. If you are familiar with something like Excel or spreadsheets in general, for any given cell, you can configure a formula, and that formula is used by Excel to calculate the value that would be displayed right in that cell. Very similarly, with generated columns in Backendless, you can provide a formula, what we actually call it expression, that would be used by the database itself to calculate the value for that column. So for example, let's imagine that you have a table where you have a bunch of products, and for each product you have the price of how much that product cost and the amount of tax that would need to be calculated. So using the formula, you can easily calculate the value of the final price, which would basically be the price of the product plus the amount of the tax. So that formula would be fairly straightforward, but you could actually create some very complex formulas because we support more than 100 different operators and functions that you could use to work with your data. And those functions, they apply for mathematical processing or string manipulation or date manipulation. You can actually do conditional statements. So you can sort of create like, if this value equals something or greater than or less than, then the value for the cell is going to be this. Or and continue on, so you could actually have fairly lengthy conditional statements. So this is quite exciting. Once you create that generated column, you can create other generated columns that reference that one. From the API perspective, whenever you query the database, you can configure your where clause, that the where clause references generated columns and their values. Of course, when you retrieve data from the database, it includes the values for the generated columns that you configured. In Backendless console, the actual generated columns, when you go to the data browser, it has a different, slightly different visualization just to suggest that these are generated columns. The possibilities are really infinite. There are a couple of blog articles that we posted with information on the available functions and some examples on how to use them. You can find links to those articles right in the description for this very video. But for now, let me just jump into a demonstration just to show how it works and what it looks like, so you can get a feel of how cool and exciting this feature is. To demonstrate how generated columns work, I will jump right into the Backendless database, which is the data screen. And here we will create a new table called math. And as you can guess, that will be our playground for mathematical or math-related generated columns. Create the table, and we will declare two columns. One of them is going to be called OP1, which stands for operand 1. It will be of type integer. And the second one is going to be a column called OP2, which will also be an integer. By the way, there is another cool feature that there is a checkbox that says create another, and if it is selected when you create, this pop-up will stay in place. But this is another on another topic, because right now we're talking about generated columns. So here we have two columns, OP1 and OP2, and we can populate them. Actually, let's not populate them with any data now, but let's just create our first generated column, and it will be as basic as the sum or the addition of two operands. So in order to create generated column, just select this generated column checkbox. There's a little tooltip that says what generated columns are. We will select the data type. It is important to select one. You're gonna need to know what will be the outcome of your function or the expression. And then right here is the actual expression. So this is the formula that will guide the database as to what needs to be done, how the value needs to be generated. So for our example, by the way, the name of the column will be sum. And as you can tell, it is going to be op1 plus op2. Simple as this. Click create. The column is there. You see that there is a little label that says it is generated. You can go back and edit it just by clicking this icon right here. But if we go back to data browser,
and let's just add a couple of values. So let's say if it is OP1 is 2 and then OP2 is 5, click enter. And as you can see, the value for the column sum automatically appeared there. So the database has calculated the value. And then here you can just put in any two numbers and enter, and the value will be automatically calculated. The same thing is true for using the APIs. So here, if I go to REST console, and let's just say I'm going to create an object where OP1 is 10 and OP2 is 5. And I'm going to use put to create the object, and the object created, and then in the response, the sum is already there. The database did its job, calculated the value, and returned it back to you. This is really, really cool. Now, but we are just scratching the surface, because the operator of addition is just the most basic. There are so many cool things that you can do in there. So let's enhance our schema and add some additional columns. So for instance, if we want to do square root, we can call this column SQRT, which stands for square root. The value will be double, because if we select int, it's going to be truncated. It is a generated column. And then to calculate the square root, Backendless provides a function called SQRT. And then here we can put the column or a specific value. It needs to be basically a value that the function will take. So let's say we're going to be calculating the square root of OP1. Click create. So now the function is there. And if we go back to data browser, you can see that there is a square root calculation for OP1. So if we enter, let's say 16 right here, then the square root is going to be 4, which is basically proves that the square root calculation in Backendless generated columns works. What other things can you do? Well, a lot. There is a random number generator. There is a being able to get the ceiling value or floored value, where basically it rounds up or round down. You can get an absolute value. You can get the modulo. So there are a lot of different operators. And there is a blog post that is, as I mentioned earlier, there is a link to that in the description for this video. It lists some of the functions that we support, and we're working on creating a full list that will be added to our documentation, so you can see exactly all the possibilities that exist in there. What else can you do? Can you work with strings? Well, absolutely. There are a lot of functions that allow you to work with strings. So let's add another table, and we'll call it strings test. And for columns, let's create first name. And notice that I selected create another, create, and then we'll create a last name. So now the two columns are there. And let's say that we want to have a dynamic generated column that concatenates these two values together. So let's create a column called full name. It will be generated column. The value is string. And to concatenate the two values together, there is a function called concat. And here we can say first name, comma, and then perhaps a delimiter, which could be just space, last name. Click create. So now the generated column in there. Go to data browser, and let's create a new record in here. So let's say the first name is going to be Joe, and the last name is going to be Doe. As you can see, the full name is automatically calculated. There is another function in there which we can modify this full name. It is called concat underscore WS, and WS stands for with separator. So the first parameter is going to be the separator. So we can specify it like this, which is going to be comma space. It can be any separator you want. And then after that, you specify the values that need to be concatenated with this separator. Click update. It is in there. Go to data browser. And now it is Joe comma Doe. This column is there. You can actually reference it in the where clause. You can create other generated columns that reference this one. So it works just like any other column, but the thing about it that is different is that the database calculates its value. What other things can you do? Well, you can create conditional expressions. That is an expression that includes a conditional statement. To demonstrate conditional processing and conditional statements and generated columns, I will go back to the math table. And in here, in schema, I will create a generated column that will essentially analyze the value of OP1, and then we'll determine whether it's negative, positive, or zero. Let's see how that will work. So let's call it OP1Info. That's going to be the name of the column. It is generated, and the value is going to be string. So check this out. This is going to be the syntax of the generated column that uses conditions. So we're going to say case, and then you'll say when OP1 is less than zero, then the value is going to be negative. When OP1 equals zero, then zero. Else, positive. And you finish it with the word and. So now the generated column is created. Go back to data browser. And as you can see here, all these values are positive. Let's create a new one where OP1 is 0, and then OP2 is just some number. So as you can see, the OP1 info says it is 0. And let's create one where it is negative value, and then something for OP2. It needs to be a number. So here it says negative. As you can see, this is very, very cool. And your conditional statements can analyze ranges. It can analyze with if it is a string, if it starts with a certain letter or character or substring. So pretty much everything is possible. The possibilities here are infinite. And that's what makes this feature extremely, extremely cool. I hope this gives you an idea of how generated columns work, what they are, and gives you some ideas into how you can use them in your applications. Thank you for watching this, and as always, happy coding.